Jest program High Cash Week Special. Oh yes! Dowiedzieliśmy się, że Aleksander Sasza Galicki z firmy Almaz Capital był w Polsce i nie moglibyśmy uniknąć sytuacji, gdzie on by udzielił nam wywiadu. I dzisiejsze rozmowy właściwie będzie w języku angielskim, bo nie wiem, czy wiecie, ale ja jestem Anglikiem. Fakt. Niektórzy myślą, że ja mówię ze francuskim akcentem po polsku, a to wcale nie jest prawda. Więc tak, we're gonna switch to English now. Welcome, okay. Sasha, how's it going?
Okay, it is good.
How's it going? You flown in for a few days?
A few days, as usual, for any place where I'm going.
Probably you spend quite a lot of time on flights and in different kind of countries.
Yeah, it is for more than a million on each, possibly Star Airlines and everything.
I need his air miles, I'm telling you.
Oh, I can give you some.
We'll talk after this. Right, I'm going to be very brutal, Sasha.
Okay,
what
no problem.
What pisses you off about Polish companies? And there must be some kind of frustration you have about dealing with Polish startups.
Yeah, during the last few years, we are coming here and living and coming and living. And when we speak to local guys, they always think about local market. And it's frustrating, since sometimes they have not bad idea. You look on this idea, but you would like to see a team who would like to go global. You would like to see the guys who would like to achieve something. And they told, no, we'll stay here for some period of time. We'll prove concept. We have some customers. We have Warsaw Stock Exchange. We'll go public. We'll make money.
And then we'll try a different.
And after we'll try. And I told, it will be too late, you know? So then, since any idea which started in the world can be started by many people in the same time, like babies going everywhere, yeah. So, and from this perspective, you see that guys who started in US, especially in B2B business, you cannot do B2C business global, but B2B business need to be global from day one. And if you start late, so all place are taken. So you're coming and started to put your shoulders and try to get there, but it is too big competition. So it is frustrating.
So if you're talking to a startup, let's say, because probably you talk to startups of all kinds, but somebody who has an idea but hasn't executed, would your recommendation be to think global, as in basically English language market straight away?
If they, you know, it is one more problem for any, I will say not just Polish, but any European startup. So any engineer, when he found idea, he started to write code. For example, if he's a software guy, he's not going to validate idea. So he's not going to customers, he thinks he found problem and he would like to solve it. Or some business guys found some problem and they're going to hire some engineers to build and solve the problem, but they did not investigate anything. Yeah. It is frustrating as well.
Worst thing in the world is a pitch by a group of engineers.
I'm sure somehow I was like this guy when I started, so I understand them. So it is for me much easier to speak to them, since I understand that they're doing mistakes which I did more than 20 years ago.
But you've had a few successes since then. We're going to talk about that as well. Now, we're very proud in Poland that we have such amazing programmers and developers. Do you think that's the other trap that we have in Poland, that we're basically like a country that produces guys that can build but maybe can't sell?
No, it is experience, you know. It is need to be some kind of serial entrepreneurs who came and went and back, make mistakes and back again to do it. And they're taking risk, and risk appreciated, and failing appreciated, and people support them. I mean, from state government programs and everything, not prosecutor knocking door at 6 a.m. at morning, where's my money? Yeah, so, but government, state money. So it is need to be like culture. So the culture which support entrepreneurs, since smart people everywhere, but engineering forces here is very strong. What you need to add here, it is knowledge. Yeah, so knowledge how to build products, first of all. The second knowledge it is to how to go and scale company on the global market. Since you'll be successful only if you're targeting biggest market and where the available funding. So here available funding for low stage, what I found, like seed investment and people thinking by seed investment, and they stock on 3 million revenue, and after they don't know what to do. It is not enough to go abroad. It is not enough to be big, it is enough to do something special. So, and it is no money here, actually, to bring these guys to the next step. So,
You've actually set up businesses that have been successful, and you were living some time in the United States. We're sometimes jealous of the fact that in the US they have this fail fast culture where it's okay to be not successful before you are successful. I'm British, so I kind of a little bit in between, but definitely I've noticed in Poland there's a culture where we don't like to admit that we were wrong or the mistake wasn't a good idea. Do you think a fail fast culture is a good thing?
Yeah, Yeah, and more important is the difference between Europe and between the US, that in Europe any company focus on growth and here on profitability. So, and it is slow down development. So what is more important, to get more customers and to get profitability? So, and it is even, I'm listening to local venture capitalists that told you need to go to be profitable. So it is impossible, you need to grow.
Because VCs are looking for companies that are growing super fast and aren't too worried about losing money in the short term.
No, VC is losing money, come on. So yeah, we are losing money, we understand that from 10 investments we are losing most of them. So, but possibly they will become zombie, like sitting on the between and not growing, but few champions will bring you return and few champions can repeat again.
You mentioned something about government state interventions to see a little bit of seed funding, some incubators, etc. The startup scene in Poland has exploded in recent years. How would you assess Polish government support relative to other European countries and the US?
No, first of all, it is general European problem. General European problems that state money provided for the seed investment and possibly all the stage investment, and you need to be build your company in the local soul. Yeah, so. And it is stop entrepreneur to think global, since he is getting money to build company in the place where he was born. But today, all business global. So even in Europe, it is not so many trans-border investors. It is a problem. So it is few, like Amadeus in UK, for example, it is like cross-border. I speak to them, and the CEO of the company of Amadeus told me, oh, we're cross-border, we do UK, and we do Nordic, and we do a little bit of some other countries. It is not global. Yeah. So, and it is leading company. So, and you don't have too many. So it is a problem that European money need to think more global. Not just entrepreneurs.
So in the meantime, whilst we wait for these governments to sort out how they're actually going to support entrepreneurs, and the US is so dynamic and so explosive, what do you think we can learn from the American entrepreneurial culture?
No, the main point is, you know, when you build any product, you need to count that, or build the company, you need to count that only 25% you spent on idea, technology, and prototype. And 75% how to get to market, how to build right product for market, and how to organize the sales. And it is what people need to learn. It is you need to get experience, you need to get mentors. It is what you need to learn. You need to be ready to grow fast.
Amaz Capital has an interesting model because you have guys in Europe, people sorry, in Europe, and you also have people in the US at the same time. So you have an office, I think, in is it San Francisco or Silicon Valley?
In next to Stanford.
Okay, so let's just describe the process then. I'm at the stage where maybe I've got some Series A funding or something like that. I come to you guys, I'm ready to now take it a step forward.
Okay, so first of all, we are looking for companies which is ready to go. I mean ready mentally. Does not mean that they are ready completely. So we help them. So the main point is to bring the talent there, the talent, management talent, and marketing talent. So from this perspective, we usually sign up for company two partners. One is working from US office, and one is working hunting here from European office. And from this perspective, we try to help them to make right mentality to move, since when the company growing, founder can be lost, yeah, in this time. So, and so this is a little bit like different from any others, since usually it is one partner who oversees a company. We're doing two. So, and the second one, it is very important. We built very strong link in Silicon Valley. So the main point for us, it is to get credibility to us and credibility to our companies, since Sequoia or others, they will not often here. So they are coming one time per year, two times per year, and possibly looking for bigger companies, not the small companies. So for us, important to prepare company to the next growth. And after this, it is getting pretty fast to grow.
So let's talk about the pitching process then. Before I get to go to Silicon Valley with you, I have to come in and actually pitch to you. Yeah. And if I'm a Polish developer turned CEO who doesn't really like talking very much, how am I supposed to do that? What advice would you give somebody to structure their pitch and how to perform their pitch?
No, it is pretty standard. Yes, so you need to indicate problem and how you solve this problem. You need to show this problem really exists. To prove it, you need to have some validation with someone on the market, not just I told I will fight with Google or I'll fight with some company. Yeah? So you need to show that you know market. And from other side, you need to show that you at least know the steps. But more important is that when people don't know what to do, if they will show that they're solving problems, they are coming with idea, okay, it is my lack, I have these problems in my management team, I have this problem in myself, I don't know this one, this one. And it is mainly important to get from people. Since when you invest, you stay with people for 5-7 years usually. If it is B2B, like serious technology company, you spend in this company 5, 7, sometimes 10 years. And it is a long time. It is like you like jump to family relationship. Yes, so you have pretty good stuff. It is very important to show your weaknesses. It is important to show your knowledge and weaknesses. In this case, it is easy to go after this. Since after this, you're doing due diligence, you understand the guys are right, doing the technical due diligence, that it is really working or can work if they will go right decision in technical direction. So it is pretty easy, it is standard, nothing special. But we select, first of all, team, after this, market. It is market growing fast. How fast is growing market? How big is market? Since you need to have ability to have pivots. And after this, we are looking, okay, it is a great technology or not great technology.
Thank you, Sasha. That was, I would call that awesome advice, which po polsku I don't know how to exactly say, but was certainly very useful. Z nami w studiu był Aleksander Sasza Galicki z firmy Almaz Capital i to naprawdę był senny rola dla młodych polskich przedsiębiorców. Przestańcie myśleć właściwie tylko i wyłącznie o polskim rynku. Zaczynamy właściwie od pomysłu do egzekucji, zawsze z myśleniem, jak będziemy sprzedawać poza Polską i właściwie przekonać firmy Venture Capital do wsparcia naszej ekspansji. Dziękuję serdecznie, Sasze. Do zobaczenia. To był odcinek High Cash Week Special. I pamiętajcie, jeżeli znasz kogoś, który chce założyć własną firmę, który ma fajny pomysł, który na przykład buduje dobrą firmę, to wyślij tej osoby jak najszybciej, bo to naprawdę były wartościowe informacje. Cześć i do zobaczenia. Ciao, ciao.